Former Solicitor General calls on the Philippine government to file a new arbitral case against China from severely damaging reefs in the West Philippine Sea. Zen Hernandez reports.
Lifeless. This is how the Philippine Coast Guard described the maritime ecosystem that divers found during an underwater survey of both Rosal Reef and Escuada Shoal. In the video, the seabed was almost flattened and covered in what appears to be crushed corals. According to the PCG, this strongly suggests dumping or the act of disposing previously harvested corals. Surveys in Escuada Shoal also revealed visible discoloration of the seabed, which the PCG also sees as an indication of deliberate activities to modify the natural topography of the underwater terrain. Coincidentally, the PCG was able to monitor a proliferation or swarming of Chinese maritime militia vessels in the West Philippine Sea at the same time the coral destruction was discovered. From August 9 to September 11, 33 Chinese maritime militia vessels were monitored around Rosal Reef and 15 in Escuada Shoal. From Palawan, Rosal Reef, also known as Iroquois, is only 160 nautical miles, a distance similar to travel between Manila and Camarines Sur. Escuada or Sabina Shoal is even closer, at 134 nautical miles, the same distance from Manila to Baguio. Both features are within the 200 nautical mile exclusive economic zone of the Philippines. The PCG is now coordinating with experts from the University of the Philippines Marine Science Institute for the launch of further underwater surveys that will map the actual extent of damage on the maritime ecosystem in the West Philippine Sea.
That is something that we have yet to figure out. That's the reason why we intend to carry out another maritime patrol and underwater survey sa mga susunod na araw.
The Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources strongly condemned the damage to the corals in Rosal Reef and Escuada Shoal, saying that the massive damage to the ecosystem has long been caused not only by illegal fishing, but by China's reclamation activities as well.
Inilalagay din ito sa alanganing sitwasyon ang fish sufficiency at ang food security ng lahat ng mga bansang nasa region. May pag-aaral na po dyan na ginawa ang Marine Research Science Institute ng University of the Philippines. No? Sinabi na nasa 31 billion pesos ang nawawala sa atin dahil sa mga reclamation activities na nangyayari dyan sa West Philippines. At yun nga, nakakalungkot na ang may gawain nito ay mga dayuhan.
Former Supreme Court Associate Justice Francis Hardeleza, meanwhile, is urging President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. to file another arbitral case for damages. Hardeleza was the Solicitor General or Government Legal Counsel under the Aquino administration that won the 2016 Arbitral Award. He says it is important to put a value on economic losses from environmental degradation caused by illegal activities of Chinese maritime militia vessels, as well as the impact on the national government's expenses caused by dangerous maneuverings of the Chinese Coast Guard every time the Philippine resupply mission sets out for Ayungin Shoal. Hardeleza believes all of this will make for a strong case.
Nothing will happen without the go signal of the president. So talking, the first step is to authorize the OSG to study. Tingnan mo yan, apat na incidents na, may water cannon, may ano. Panglima na itong the recent one, and binola na naman tayo kasi crisscross na lang.
Hardeleza further explained that unlike the 2016 arbitral ruling, a case on environmental damages is enforceable since courts have authority to seize assets of a country in other countries. Senator Francis Tolentino, chairman of the Senate Special Committee on Maritime and Admiralty Zones, supports filing an environmental case before the International Tribunal on the Laws of the Sea and the International Court of Justice. He also showed before and after photos of Escuada Shoal to emphasize the extent of the damage. Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri also strongly criticized China for the incident.
Bakit? Bakit po nila ginawa yun? Kaya umaapela po ako sa China, and the Chinese embassy to stop the wanton destruction of our coral reefs and our coral resources in the West Philippine Sea.
The Armed Forces of the Philippines Western Command reported that as of September 15, almost 50 Chinese maritime militia vessels were spotted around Rosal Reef, Barangatan Ornatas Back, and Escoda Shoal. Efforts are underway to increase patrols, but the AFP Westcom also admits limited resources. To increase law enforcement capability, the Philippines is currently in talks with several allied nations to conduct joint patrols and ensure freedom of navigation in the entire South China Sea. Zen Hernandez, ABS-CBN News.
The Department of Foreign Affairs, meanwhile, says it's seriously concerned about reports of destruction of corals in the Rosal Reef. Without mentioning China, it calls on everyone concerned to act responsibly and stop activities that can damage the marine environment. Bishop Oak in Zambales slammed the presence of Chinese vessels in Scarborough Shoal, which they say threatens their safety and livelihood. Scarborough Shoal falls within the exclusive economic zone of the Philippines, but China continues to claim it. Now, the New Masinloc Fishermen's Association says Chinese vessels swarm the area, making them unable to fish there. Some fishermen have completely stopped sailing out of fear of being harassed by China.
Masakit din sa kalooban namin dahil sa sarili namin pangingisda. Kami parin ito natabi kami din. Tsaka maraming mga Chinese visit doon. Hindi kayo nakapangisda doon dahil nga doon sa ano. Kita ka doon pag lumapit ka doon sa ano sa may malapit sa Bukana. May baka pa nga doon nakaangkurahe sa loob.
Okay.
Maliban yung sa labas.
Malagit talaga yung tiktok gawa ng China. Kasi po, nung talagang trip pa yung Scarborough po, talagang halos isang araw ka lang may isda, uuwi ka na. Dahil sa dami ng isda. Pero ngayon wala na.
The Philippine Coast Guard, meanwhile, assures fishermen of its presence in the Ayun Shoal.
2 weeks ago, the Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources, together with NECA and of course the Coast Guard, were able to patrol that area. We have rotational deployment of our vessels together with BFAR in Bajo de Masinloc. But it's partly true that it's not every time you can find a Coast Guard or BFAR vessel in Bajo de Masinloc.
Philippine Supreme Court asked to declare the Maharlika Investment Fund unconstitutional. Former Bayanuna Party List representatives Neri Polminares, Carlos Zarate, and Ferdinand Gaite filed the petition Monday. They are joined as petitioners by Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel. They argue there was no public calamity or public emergency when President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. certified the bill as urgent. They add the law is a disaster waiting to happen because it did not go through a test of economic viability.
During this time that there's a worldwide, in fact, recession, no? Yung ibang malalaking bansa nga ay ingat na ingat sila, no? Pero ito, ang Pilipinas, tayo, gumawa tayo ng ganitong pondo, niligay sa isang korporasyon na napaka hindi sigurado yung accountability.
Vinilate din yung constitutional requirement na independent dapat ang Bangko Sentral. Ang Maharlika ay hindi independent sa Malacanang. At maaring gamitin ang pondo nito sa korupsyon o cronyism.
The Marcos administration focusing on the Filipino youth and its fight against fake news. The Presidential Communications Office says it will personally engage with schools and communities for its media information literacy campaign. It asserts the youth are the most vulnerable to the massive disinformation pounding the digital landscape.
Tungkol sa mga celebrities, sa mga bata na like sa Pilipinas, nakikita natin yung DSWD, number one na nagiging information, nagiging source ng disinformation. Yung mga ayuda na binibigay ng gobyerno, yung iba naman talagang character assassination, yun yung mga nakikita natin talaga. So yun ang noon namin nakikita na yung mga bata talaga ang nagiging mas pinaka-vulnerable.
Meanwhile, the PCO refutes claims the campaign will only be used as a platform to revise history. Critics of Marcos claim the president himself employed disinformation to revamp his family's name. Philippine House Speaker Martin Romualdez appeals to oil firms to help curb domestic fuel costs by cutting their profit margins. Romualdez requested this during a closed-door meeting Monday with energy officials and oil industry executives. The oil companies, in turn, urged the government to suspend the excise tax on fuel.
I've also gotten some feedback from some of our congressmen here. Baka we can exercise this backwardization that we can already perhaps even explore buying oil early or in advance, no? And not wait till December. So baka we can get better prices by securing our oil requirements by making advance purchases or orders.